Hi everyone, it's Cindy Johnson, your instructor for HIT 221, and I wanted to just go through the code book and see if we can't get you a little more familiar with that. I'm using a document camera, which I'm not super familiar with, but hopefully this will help me show you things. So, looking at the table of contents, you can see the different chapters, those types of things. But pay attention to here where we look at the steps to correct coding, the format, the punctuation, the abbreviation, the additional conventions, different ways that the code book uses edits and color, the guidelines, which we'll spend a lot of time on this semester getting very familiar with guidelines, and then the various tables. There's an index to diseases and injuries, which we just refer to as the index when I tell you to look at the alphabetical index. That's what I'm referring to. Then there's a neoplasm table, which is neoplasms or cancers. We learn to use that table. A table of drugs and chemicals, index to external causes, and then we actually start the tabular. So you'll see when you read the codes, the steps to coding, you start with looking up a main term in your alphabetical index, and then you take the code that you are given and then you look that code up in your tabular. And the tabular is divided into the various chapters. And you will notice that the chapters, chapter one is certain infectious and parasitic diseases, does not correspond to chapter one in the coding handbook. So just be aware they don't correspond and look for references in the assignment schedule that tell you which chapters. For example, chapter 14 in the coding handbook corresponds to chapter 1 in the code book. Some history of ICD-9. These notes here where it talks about the inclusion terms and excludes 1, excludes 2, these are really important. So don't just gloss over the punctuation and the instructional notes, because really they are like if you're driving a car, and I'll try to make that analogy throughout the course. If you're driving a car and the speed limit changes, or there's a caution sign, that's what instructional notes are. They're giving you instructions for how you move forward in finding your code. So do pay attention to those. And you'll see, this is my code book. You're going to see where I have written notes to myself about different things throughout the code book. We'll learn more about that as time goes on. Let's see what else. Then you get to the official guidelines. Let me move this down. Sorry. The official guidelines for coding and reporting. And again, we will talk about guidelines over and over and over. The only way you know or learn a guideline is to use it. So I have many examples on the exercises and in our exams that will have you referring often back to the guidelines. You can see where I have made my own highlights for different things. I mentioned in one of the recordings, I think it was the assignment schedule, that I had to learn ICD-10 as well. I learned to code in 9. So it has been an education to learn to code in 10. I like it, but it is very different than 9. So the guidelines, there's several pages of them. Now you will see some of them, after you get past the general guidelines, you see chapter-specific guidelines. So you will notice that as you move through these. I also wanted to show you my tabs. I tab everything because it helps me find things quicker. So you can have your own system of how you want to tab. I identify the index, the alphabetical index, and then I just have a couple of alphabet letters, like this is the letter D in the index, the letter F in the index, P for pregnancy in the index, just to kind of give me a quick thumb. And that is all of the alphabetical index. Then I have a tab for the table of neoplasms here. I call it the neoplasm. And that's where we start with this neoplasm table. Again, you see I have some notes up here. This very same note is in here, but it's just written so small. So if I really want to remember something, I'll make an extra note up here at the top to help me remember. We'll learn more about the neoplasm table when we get to chapter 2 in the code book. Let me see if I can show you. See here how we have malignant primary. This is when the primary cancer is in a certain organ. Malignant secondary, this is when the cancer has metastasized from this organ to a secondary organ. Cancer in situ, which is a description that the doctor is going to be giving you. Benign is a cancer that's benign. Uncertain, you will rarely use this code. Almost certainly the doctors are going to tell you it's either benign or malignant. Unspecified behavior, I've never used this column, but I'm sure it's there for a reason. But just to be aware that for the most part, you're going to be using these first four columns when we get to the table of neoplasms. Then if we move to my next tab, after neoplasms, I have drugs and chemicals right here. The table of drugs and chemicals. So I'm going to come back up here. And what I want to bring to your attention here, let me adjust this camera. You would be, when we get to this point, you'll be looking up substances, and then you'll be looking at these headings. And the first one is an accidental poisoning, which is unintentional. Then the second column is an intentional poisoning to harm yourself. Then a poisoning for an assault where you're harming someone else. A poisoning is undetermined. In other words, we don't know who's hurting who. And then the adverse effect is a drug that's taken in the correct dose, but this patient has a reaction to it, adverse effect. And underdosing is when a prescription has been written, but the patient's not using it the way it's been prescribed. So we'll learn a lot more about this. I just wanted to bring this table to your attention as we're going through the code book. My next tab is external causes, right here, another table. And again, this will make a lot more sense when we get to these chapters, but I just wanted to kind of walk you through the code book so you can see it does have some order. It's just a very large book. And then I start with the letter A for chapter 1. In the back of the book, I want to show you a couple of things. In the very back, I have, there's illustrations. The peripheral nervous system is here. So I have PNS for peripheral nervous system. This is going to be your sense organs. So just don't forget about these things in the back of the book. And I have them labeled. You can see my little labels here. Just to help me find them quickly when I'm coding. So hopefully that's just an introduction to the book. We'll spend a lot of time in this book. You'll become very, very familiar with it. Those illustrations we just looked at, here they are. So I hope this has been a little bit helpful so that you can spend some time getting in the code book and figuring out what's what, and we will learn together how best to use this very large amount of codes. Thank you, have a good morning. Bye-bye.